Got my trusty TV M50 cow, and hopefully I could pull it off. Not really gonna try and get in front of the camera this time. It's gonna be very difficult with a few days left. I'm gonna try and fill my tag. I know a lot of other guys that got some tags. We might do a Saturday hunt where at least I can help them out, maybe film or help drive. But I'm gonna go out and see what I can do. Hopefully I can sneak up on some deer. Was out with a friend yesterday. It was so cold, almost a whiteout. Couldn't get any footage. Saw all kinds of deer and just couldn't make it happen. So I'm gonna go out again and see if I can fill my final tag. Trying to fill my second tag isn't going to be any easier than it was filling the first one, I tell you that. Snuck right up on a deer. That thing was, I don't know, 30 yards from where I'm standing right now. And there's another one, had its head tucked underneath on the back side of it, so I couldn't even tell what it was, but there's too much brush to take a shot at that one anyways. And the one that I did have the camera set up, I had no idea if it was a button buck or not. And I didn't really want to shoot it in the head. I couldn't see, and then when it faced towards me, I was kind of hoping it would stand up. I couldn't get it to stand up. And I was being really still, so it had no idea where in the world I was. I think it tried to see me, because I tried to move a little bit just to, for it to maybe stand up and maybe stomp its feet or something, but It's getting to the point where I can't even move my lips to talk because it's so cold, and my knee is really, really bothering me really bad. I don't even know if I'm gonna be able to go out tomorrow. I don't think it's the cold weather. It's just, I messed with a lair earlier in the week, and it was starting to hurt. Just, I couldn't even bend it. Now it's getting to the point where I've been neglecting it and not taking a rest, running up and down these hills. It's hurting pretty bad right now, so I think I'm just gonna call her a day. There's maybe an hour and a half left of daylight, but I ain't doing it. I'm gonna probably go hunt my way back to the truck and maybe go out Saturday. I don't know if I'll go out Friday or not, but sneaking right up on them. But I you know, I wanted to make sure that I take a good shot at a good sized doe. Even if that was a doe, a small doe, I still would have filled the tag with it if it would have stood up and given me a good shot, but it didn't. And oh well, I mean, that's the way it goes. It's hunting. Well, it's the last day of flintlock season. We got Tim and Andy here, and I'm still gonna be hunting period dress, so we're gonna see if we can get some deer. My cousins are doing their big grouse hunt today, so they'll be moving some deer today too. It's probably, what, 10 degrees out right now? It is freezing, and you know, that's not even counting the wind chill, so hopefully we got Cody behind the camera and see if we can get any deer today. We're out in the last hour. Tim got a shot at one and I got one down. These deer come into these pines and I didn't have the camera. Cody had the camera. Hey, last day, last hour, it was time to make meat with the flintlock. So when I come up around here, I drove the pines out once. They said, we didn't see anything. Now Cody just watched a whole bunch of deer running in here, and I said, well, I'm gonna do the drive again because I just come through here and they didn't come out. I said, I'm gonna do it again. So I went up on the hill. Now it's field up on top, and I caught them. They were all bedded in a really thick spot where I walked right past them. Well, being up on top of the hill, they saw me. The big deer all ran, and there was one left that stood up, 100 yard offhand shot. And to be honest, it was windy up there, so it took like 4 or 5 clicks before the gun even went off. And I hit it, I watched it go down after 40 yards, it crashed. I got down there, it got back up and ran, crashed again another 50 yards, and when I found it the second time, it wasn't moving, it was dead. But it's not a very big deer, but hey, it's the last hour, and Tim shot at one. The deer were right here, come right out the trail, but we're gonna go see if he hit, see if he got one or not, but we'll get on the trail, get back to you here in a little bit. So right there's some blood. It's getting pretty dark, especially in these pines, so we're gonna keep on her. There's lots of good blood here. It's really coming out.
Where am I going? Uh-oh. Yep. Right.
Congratulations.
Right on. Well, it's my fault because I thought you missed it. Well, hey. Don't always listen to me. You have to learn that.
Boy, I tell you what. You know what, Tim? That thing looks like it should be little, but that thing is big.
Really?
It looks big. Well, the head of it looks like a young deer, but it's big. It's a really big deer. Here is my second deer of the 2014-2015 season. It is a very tiny deer. And I tell you what, when it's the last hour, you can't be too picky. You know, it really doesn't matter in this late season whether it's a big deer or a little deer, because the little deer, the good thing about the little deer is chances are it's not pregnant. But the negative is you don't get the meat. But with a big deer, a big doe, the chances are this late in the season, it's January 10th. Most likely she's probably pregnant, bred by a big buck. So taking her, you're actually taking out more deer out of the herd. But here with the population of the doe, it doesn't matter whether you're taking a big deer or a little deer. This will be good eating size, good dragging size out of here. There's the innie right here. Looks like it was just a hair back, but it looks like it probably would have been a lung shot because, like I said, she crashed in no time. And it come out right behind the front shoulder on the opposite side. So that's a pretty good season for me. Like I said, I want to thank Cody and Tim for coming out and just being part of this last day season. It's been cold. We've hunted hard, and it was hard finding deer today. And, you know, I want to thank Kevin for the rifle again, and thanks, Jim, for helping me with the outfit and sighting this gun in. It's just truly blessed. And till next year. So we got Joe again. We got the grouse hunters, and again. The wooden bowl for the
Caesar salad.
Caesar salad.
This is like our 20th year in a row at the Nugent Camp on the Great Grouse Safari. We always make Caesar salad.
You guys got one grouse today.
That was it.
Jimmy got the grouse today. Dogs are worn out. All right, Joe, what's this?
This is tenderloins out of an elk I killed in October in Wyoming. What we did, we just rubbed it earlier today, and we're just gonna black it on a cast iron skillet with some butter. And I have some raspberry balsamic vinaigrette reduction, or whatever you want to call it. We're going to drizzle that on there when we're done. And it's going to taste pretty good.
Yeah, it smells amazing.
We have our sweet potatoes there that Mr. Nugent did with sliced them down, buttered them, a little brown sugar syrup on there. Sweet as you can get, man. Yeah.
Final product.
Just slicing this bad boy up.
Give this video of this like steak bigger than life.
That's good. Thank you.
Danielle says it's really, really good.
Just enough to bring out some extra flavor.
Yeah.
That elk is, it's hard to beat, man. It's so tender, it just looks really good.
Danielle made some homemade pumpkin pie.
Man.
Yeah. We stopped at the gas station. We're doing anything besides.
And we got our ice cream and Hershey's chocolate.
On the pie?
And got the homemade Cool Whip.
On the pie.
Okay.
Yes.
Oh, baby, homemade Cool Whip.
And you don't have to be shy about it, Jimmy.
Make sure it's not for everybody, though. Yeah.
Thing I like about